What is transfer learning? The idea of transfer learning is to leverage the knowledge acquired by a model trained with lots of data on another task. The model A will be trained specifically for task A. Now let's say you want to train model B for a different task. One option would be to train the model from scratch. This could take lots of computation, time, and data. Instead, we could initialize model B with the same weights as model A, transferring the knowledge of model A on task B. When training from scratch, all the model's weights are initialized randomly. In this example, we are training a BERT model on the task of recognizing if two sentences are similar or not. On the left, it's trained from scratch, and on the right, it's fine-tuning a pre-trained model. As we can see, using transfer learning on the pre-trained model yields better results. And it doesn't matter if you train longer. The training from scratch is capped around 70% accuracy, while the pre-trained model beats the 86% easily. This is because pre-trained models are usually trained on large amounts of data that provides the model with a statistical understanding of the language used during pre-training. In computer vision, transfer learning has been applied successfully for almost 10 years. Models are frequently pre-trained on ImageNet, a dataset containing 1.2 million of photo images. Each image is classified by one of 1,000 labels. Training like this, on labeled data, is called supervised learning. In natural language processing, transfer learning is a bit more recent. A key difference with ImageNet is that the pre-training is usually self-supervised, which means it doesn't require human annotation for the labels. A very common pre-training objective is to guess the next word in a sentence, which only requires lots and lots of text. GPT-2, for instance, was pre-trained this way using the content of 45 million links posted by users on Reddit. Another example of self-supervised pre-training objective is to predict the value of randomly masked words, which is similar to fill-in-the-blank tests you may have done in school. BERT was pre-trained this way using the English Wikipedia and 11,000 unpublished books. In practice, transfer learning is applied on a given model by throwing away its head, that is, its last layers focused on the pre-training objective, and replacing it with a new, randomly initialized head suitable for the task at hand. For instance, when we fine-tuned the BERT model earlier, we removed the head that classified masked words and replaced it with a classifier with two outputs, since our task had two labels. To be as efficient as possible, the pre-trained model used should be as similar as possible to the task it's fine-tuned on. For instance, if the problem is to classify German sentences, it's best to use a German pre-trained model. But with the good comes the bad. The pre-trained model does not only transfer its knowledge, but also any bias it may contain. ImageNet mostly contains images coming from the United States and Western Europe. So models fine-tuned with it usually will perform better on images from these countries. OpenAI also studied the bias in the prediction of its GPT-3 model, which was pre-trained using the guess the next word objective. Changing the gender of the prompt from he was very to she was very changed the predictions from mostly neutral objectives to almost only physical ones. In the model card of the GPT-2 model, OpenAI also acknowledges its bias and discourages its use in systems that interact with humans.